who give you a holistic view of the complete visitor's economy.
Travel and tourism contributes to 9% of the GDP. 255 million jobs depend on this important industry today, one of every 11 jobs in the world. That's a lot. And now finally, we're working together and we're working aligned to demonstrate to the world the job creation and that social benefit that the industry contributes.
I'm here to send a very, very simple but strong and clear message. We're in this together.
This is not about who's representing who. This is about the millions of people that we represent when we work together as one voice.
And that is why we see PATA as the one that symbolizes where the world is heading. And that's why we need to support PATA.
The role of PATA is important to take part in collaboration with the government.
The stronger visitor economy means more travelers, more demands for air travel, aircraft, and industry personnel.
Walt Disney has said that you can design and create and build the most wonderful place in the world. It takes people to make the dream come true.
We have a great story to tell.
We don't sell products. Google doesn't sell products. We sell experiences, which is exactly what the travel industry is about. Selling the experience, capturing an audience, and then using that to be able to recapture that audience into different experiences.
We need to align our advocacy.
What does embracing the complete visitor economy mean to aviation?
It means meeting the demand.
This is a global figure, 34,000 planes, $4.5 trillion over the next 20 years. 35% of that is going to come from Asia Pacific. And the Asia Pacific growth rate in air travel exceeds the world average significantly.
PATA has been a key partner to UNWTO to push and advocate responsible, sustainable, and universally accessible tourism. We have worked with PATA so well on joint advocacy.
The public and private partnership is crucial.
All our businesses can come together to support the visitor economy. It's not just about travel, it's not just about tourism, it's about growing economies.
The vibrant economies in Asia Pacific continue to lead the world economic recovery.
There is a direct economy when it comes to travel and there is an indirect economy. Both need to work together to create an experience. It goes back to the point we don't sell products, we actually sell experiences.
The world is moving in ways and shapes that we have never imagined before. Last year, we had 1,035,000,000 international travelers crossing borders in 1 year, one out of seven of the people of the world.
And so nearly half of the world's air traffic growth in the next 20 years will be driven by travel to, from, or within the Asia-Pacific region. And therefore, Asia-Pacific will need 12,000-plus new airplanes, valued at $1.7 trillion over the next 20 years.
I must confess to you, when I came from Madrid, I was given a lecture by my statisticians and my experts there. You should not promote new terms because this confuses the people. What is this new complete visitors economy? We have very specific and very clear terms. Let's not deviate from them. Well, you know what? We all mean the same thing, and I don't care what they call them, what you call them. I know that Martin is doing the right thing and saying the right thing. And I had to say to my people, sorry, I'm going there and I'm mentioning it in my speech and I'm supporting it.